Welcome back to News 8 at 5:30. If you've been paying attention, and I know you have, the News 8 storm team has been telling us the cold weather is going to stick around for a while.
Yeehaw, but there are things you can do to stay healthy. And on your side, medical reporter Susan Shapiro had some tips on News 8 at 5, and she rejoins us now live from Ephrata, Lancaster County, with more info. Susan?
Good evening, Janelle, and it is cold out here tonight, a little bit windy too. I've put on my hat because I have always heard that you can lose about 40% to 50% of your body heat from your head. We're going to find out if that's true or not with Dr. Christopher Hager. He's here with Lincoln Family Medicine. Thanks so much for joining us out here on this cold night. Is that true or not about the head and how much heat you can lose?
It is true, and basically your body, to try to stay warm, shivers. It tries to retain as much heat as it can, and it basically shunts the blood away from the extremities into the core of the body and towards the head. And when you push all that blood to the core into the head, it naturally can be lost through the head because that's a spot that can be vulnerable and lose the heat.
All right, so the hat's a good idea.
It's a good idea, yes.
Right. What about layers? We always hear that's a good idea, too. Why is that important?
Again, anything you do, your body, temperature of 98.6, it's very important to maintain that core temperature. Anything you can do to hold the heat in that your body generates through its natural physiological processes is very important to retain, and again, it keeps you from losing the battle to the cold.
And you want to keep that clothing dry, I presume.
Keep it dry. Wetness causes you to lose the heat more rapidly.
All right, so any other suggestions for dealing with this kind of cold?
Stay warm with everything you've talked about. The layers, staying out of the wind also increases that rapidity of losing the temperature because it's, again, pulling the warm weather, the warmer temperature away. So anything you can do to bundle up and stay out of it.
And should you avoid alcohol, as we've always heard?
Yes, alcohol definitely increases the loss of warmth from your body.
All right, it's tough to talk when it gets cold,
it is
too. All right, thanks so much,
great.
Doctor. We appreciate you joining us tonight. So that's the latest on how you can try to keep warm out here in this cold. Back to you.
Yeah, he didn't mention the flying to Florida, but I guess that's kind of obvious. All right,
yeah.
Thank you, Susan.
That sounds like a very good idea to me.